Well, Sonali and me go back to when we were 18. I remember the first time she entered my store. She was the model. I was the aspiring fashion designer. Little did I realize that she'd go on to become a superstar. I'd go on to become a politician. But she'd overtake all of us by writing a book. There are certain stereotypes that we all have, and we all feel that moment you come from the film fraternity, this is somebody who can act, but when it comes to writing or speaking, there is a question mark. She undoes that in this book, because I think the modern Gurukul is about every single one of us sitting here who has children. I think the parallel that Sonali and Goldie as a couple have to our Honorable Chief Minister Amrita and Devendra Fadnavis as a couple is that both are professional parents, both working in their individual fields. In Sonali and Goldie's case, an actor, a filmmaker. In our Chief Minister's case, probably the most educated, young, honest Chief Minister Maharashtra has ever had in Devendra Fadnavis. But for most of you who don't know, his wife is not just an accomplished banker, Mr. Rana Kapoor, in the building next door. Say yes to Axis. But that apart, she's a phenomenal singer who's launched her song in Ganga Jal. Coming to the book, I'd only like to say, when I started reading it, so much of it one could relate to because one thought of parallels. I remember when I was taking care of my two kids as a guilty mother, I once asked a psychoanalyst, what is it that we do wrong? And she told me that most parents in today's day and age are overachievers for their children. So just chill, relax, and believe that it's part of the growing up. I'm glad that Sonali has referred to so many Vedic instances and experiences which make us realize that our parents did it right, and maybe if we calm down, we can do it right. So I think today's day needs to be dedicated to Ranveer as her son and Divija as Devendra and Amrita Fadnavis's adorable daughter. Thank you all.
Thank you so much. And now for the lady of the hour, you guys know her as Sonali Bendre Bell. I know her as Noona. And the reason behind that goes back a long, long way. If you want to know why, you can ask me after the event. Please welcome my aunt, Sonali Bendre Bell.
First, stop calling you aunt all the time. You know, I shouldn't have let him come here. Anyway. Namaskar. Good evening. Good afternoon. I don't know what the time is now. Very flustered, very nervous, but So happy to see you all here, and especially the Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, and the lovely, beautiful, and very, very talented Mrs. Amrita Fadnavis. Thank you so much for taking out the time and for, acknowledging the book, reading it, and giving it so much attention. Really, really indebted. Thank you so much for making it special. I especially want to thank Radha and the school. Also, Siddharth, Dr. Indu Shani has written the foreword in my book. And through her, I got introduced to this school. When I came here and I saw this school, I said, wow, this is what one talks about. The design innovation, I think, is the call of the day. And it's so lovely to see these things coming out. But because when we were growing up, there were 5 careers. And you never thought beyond that. Your parents never really thought beyond that. And I want everyone to know that look at the place. Look at what are the opportunities. Look what all you can give your kids. Just let them grow. Let them fly. Give them wings. And just see where they will go. They are our future generation. They are what is going to shape the world. And I really, really, in today's time and age, there are times when, you get really scared. I mean, there are times when I want to just switch off the television, not watch the news, because you get up scared in the night thinking, what is this world my child is going to go into? And actually, if you go back and think about it, it's about the small things. It's about compassion. If we can all be compassionate to the next person, if we can all think about the next person, I don't think it would be such a violent, aggressive world. So somewhere we need to bring up our children being more compassionate, not push them to overachieve. But anyway, all that is there in the book, and I'm not going to go into that. I think I've spoken about it when I launched the book, and I've spoke about it in the interviews and stuff like that. Here, like I said, this school, when Dr. Shani brought me here, was very inspiring. Mr. Rana Kapoor, Bindu Kapoor, all of you, really kudos. Thank you for bringing such a place here. It's amazing that you have these opportunities. The young generation has these opportunities. Thank you for this wonderful place. Am I missing anybody? Yes, there's a special friend here. Like Shaina said, she introduced me to Mr. Devendra Fadnavis and Mrs. Amrita Fadnavis. When we got talking, and I realized that these are the parents, you know, like any other, we all as parents have the same problems, same issues, same, same misgivings and same vulnerabilities. And so it was so touching when I met them and we could talk about the same things. And I said, you know, I've not really launched the book, but it's done well. I think if I could celebrate it and if you could come and launch the reprint, it would just make it so wonderful because we could identify the thought. It was the same thought. So thank you once again. And Shaina, who herself is a multitasker and an amazing parent. It's a long journey. It's been a long journey. Who would have thought we would be here today? It was golden thimble. I'm sure Aarti will remember. Yes. These are all my really old friends who have known me and been friends with me when I was a nobody. They are special and will always be special. Friends, family, all of you here who are here to support, and friends from the media also, thank you so much for this support, for this. It's really been overwhelming. Makes me feel really good. And I don't think I got so much attention when I was doing movies as I'm getting now. I love it. But yeah. The biggest thank you here is not to you, Amok, who has like opened all my can of worms, but anyway. Yes, I have, can you believe it? I have a stand-up comic who's a nephew, and actually I have to share this. My mother and my father, the Aji and Azoba, they say that, you know, guni hai mulga. But stand-up comic hai, pan mulga guni hai. You know, that's the way it is. So here he is breaking, yeah. You know, it's path breaking, he's doing different things, and it's so amazing. You know, we all come from a very middle-class Maharashtrian family. And from there, we've all kind of branched out, and we're doing these careers which are so different, definitely not run-of-the-mill. And as you can see, we all have the space for it, and it's amazing to see this happen. Very, very importantly, something that very rarely happens, and that is my three parents are here today, and this is the first time that I have my three parents here attending an event, coming out in a public platform with me, Ai, Baba, and Mom. Thank you so much for being here on my special day. I know it's a bit far away, and all the three of them never want to come so far away. Today they've been dragged out, and I said, you have to come, and they've come. They are my pillars of strength. I don't know what I would do without them. They are who I am today is because of them, and there can be nothing more and bigger than them. That's my wealth, that's my happiness, that's my family. Thank you so much once again, Ai, Baba, Mom, for being here today. Really happy to see you here. And of course, the biggest thank you goes to my partner in parenting, my partner in life. Can I say the wind beneath my wings? Because Goldie Behel, my husband, is not just my life partner, but he's someone who pushes me to do better, who pushes me to strive more, and he pushes me to, you know, reach the boundaries and try and do different things. And every time I say, no, no, I can't do this. And he says, of course you can. I can't write this book, you know. What if I don't write it properly? Then I'll be laughed at. He said, you know, since when? You look at the reviews you've got. Come on, stop feeling worried about it. Just go and write it. It can't get worse than the reviews you've got for your movies. I said, wow, what a compliment. Thank you for doing that. But yes, Goldie, thank you so much for being in my life. And I would like to invite you up here because I don't think I could have done this book or anything This parenting and this partnering couldn't be without you, so I can't do this event without you. Please, can you come and hold my hand? Yeah?
All right, so we're going to have some fun now.
You know, he has told me, don't call me on stage and don't make me speak, but I have called him and he's like actually glaring at me for that. No.
No, we're going to have some fun because I'm going to ask you guys some questions about parenting.
Why?
That I have thought of as young person. Not that anybody here is old, I'm not saying that. But you have to answer it as well as you can. So the first thing I want to ask is, who's the good cop, who's the bad cop?
The father's always the good cop.
Acha.
And how? There are very few fathers here, but a couple of them are here. The father's always the good cop.
And how moms often, agree, they are the bad cop.
How often do you have to keep switching the roles?
Because you know, he never switches the role. He's always the good cop. I'm always the bad cop. So, you know, I think Ranveer loves him more.
Cool. Does Ranveer have any social media accounts? Is he on Facebook? Is he on Twitter? And do you have access to it?
You're asking me? Yes. I totally encourage it. I think he should because he's going to do it anyways.
Correct.
So might as well. It's like when you're 18, you have a drink. When you're 10, you have a Twitter or a Facebook account.
No, you're 18. No, you have to be 23. And I've told my son that. So we are sticking to that. So, you're yeah. Ivan.
But do you have access to his Facebook account?
So I have to tell you something. What Goldie did was I'm paranoid about the digital media. And yeah. I've, in fact, very recently, a couple of months back, joined Twitter. And that was because Goldie said that, listen, you can't stop him. So rather than banning him, join him. Join the Twitter, join the social media so you can watch him. I said, ooh, that's a good idea. So yeah, at this point of time, we still have the access to his account.
And when
I'm sure there's going to be a point when he'll probably be able to block me out and I won't know how to. You will help me then.
I'll help you then. Because it'll be really weird when he's like 18 and you just log into his account and say, my mama is the best. And all his friends are like, what is wrong with him?
Yeah, but my mother does that to me. So he's never going to go away.
Yeah, you know, a mom is very, very tech savvy, actually, much more than me. So she's gotten very with it and hounds the son.
Nice. All right. My next question is, can you name 3 apps that you will never let Ranveer download on his phone?
I know only age. 3 apps that I could download, so forget not
right.
download.
So I'll help you then. You only need to stop him from downloading 1 app, Candy Crush. That's it. He'll be good. That 1 app. Do not let him download that.
Okay.
Acha. And also, when I was growing up, I remember you always got me like the coolest toys. So tell me, which is the coolest toy that Ranveer has right now?
I think I don't need to get him the toys. You know, I
think his coolest toy just now is his cricket kit. He's really into that. So yeah, I think he's just into that.
But you know, my family and friends have been getting him such amazing toys. So it's actually, rather than me getting it, he's been getting it from all of them more than me.
Awesome. Thank you so much. You can have a seat. I'm going to call on the next person now.
I'm going to call on the next
All right,
person
cool.
Yeah.
Are you
no,
sure?
No, I can't.
Are you sure? Can you? Can she? All right, cool.
Yeah?
Go for it.
Okay. I would like to call on the Honorable Chief Minister and his wife, Mrs. Samrita Fadnavis, on the stage. And I would could you do a...
Sonali, Goldie, Amruta, all the dignitaries present here, friends. Nowadays, whatever flow of your program, you may decide, but the actual flow is dictated by my friends from media.
Yeah.
So, But we must thank them because they take all this to the common people to whom we really want to reach. I would like to congratulate Sonali for this wonderful book. And the reprint itself shows that people have liked it. I could just have a glimpse of the book. I could not read it entirely. But whatever pages I could read, I think it's wonderfully written. It's all about her experience. And in very simple words, it's like a storytelling. So I think the compassion which you talked about, that can be seen in the book. All her experiences, her joys, and also the troubles which she went through. Everything has been actually written there in a very beautiful format. And I think it would really, for all aspiring parents and also those who are parents, it's a real good handbook for them. I think that being a parent is also a very wonderful thing. And as it is rightly said that a child gives birth to a mother. So I think that parenting teaches you many things. Initially, when you feel that you can think for your child, suddenly one day you know that you cannot. And you know that he or she is a entirely different entity. And at the age of 2 or 3, they start thinking for themselves. And then you suddenly realize that you have one more person in your life who is independent. And you, although care for that person, but that person has his own wishes. He has his own thinking style. He has his own aspiration. And I think that really completes your life. I think in this book, the several experiences which Sonali has written, I think everybody amongst us passes through all these phases, and the learnings which she has actually penned down gives us a sort of experienced way to handle these situations. I'm really thankful to her because I know that I'm not a good parent because I don't give much time to my daughter, but thanks to Amruta, she devotes all her time in spite of being a professional and also being a singer. So she devotes her time to her profession, to singing, and to my daughter. But whatever time I get, I try to give some quality time to my daughter. And thankfully, she also understands at this age, she is just 7. I think that the time which I spend with my daughter is the best time of my life. And that actually leads me to forget all the worries of this, being a chief minister. And I think that's a wonderful thing about parenting. So thank you, Sonali. Thank you for giving such a wonderful book to everybody. And I'm sure with this reprint and a new launch of this book, it will reach many more aspiring parents. Thank you very much.
Guys, thank you so much for coming. It was wonderful. Okay. जी जी
डॉग की बात की आपने अपने बच्चे के लिए एक और डॉग लानी है तो वो ऑब्जर्वेशन इतना कहां से आया और कैसे आपने उस चीज को मॉडल किया
आई थिंक मुझे जिस तरह से बड़ा किया गया है जो मैंने मेरे पेरेंट्स से सीखा है एंड जो जब मैं बार-बार कहती हूं कि इफ यू गो बैक टू द रूट्स का मतलब यही है कि एक्चुअली अगर आप बेसिक्स अगर आप देखो तो आपको वही सिखाते हैं सिंपल चीजें अगर आप एक एनिमल जो बोल नहीं सकता है उसके लिए अगर आप कंपैशन फील करेंगे या उसको आप प्यार करेंगे तो ऑटोमेटिकली वो बच्चा कंपैशनेट बनेगा वो दूसरों के बारे में सोचेगा. मेरे लिए आई हैव ओनली वन चाइल्ड, तो एक सिबलिंग नहीं है. तो मुझे ये लगता था कि क्या वो सेल्फिश बनेगा, हाउ विल ही लर्न टू केयर. एक छोटा भाई हो, बहन हो या कुछ हो, तो हाउ डज इट वर्क. एंड दैट्स व्हेन आई रियलाइज्ड एंड आई लव डॉग्स एंड आई हैव अ डॉग एट होम ऑलरेडी. और जब मैंने देखा कि वो जिस तरह से उसके साथ में बिहेव करता है, क्योंकि आज मेरा जो डॉग है वो 13 साल का है, जो ह्यूमन ईयर्स इज 91 ईयर्स. सो जिस तरह से वो उसके साथ बिहेव करता है, एंड देन व्हेन ही सेड मामा आई वांट अ पपी आल्सो, आई कुडंट से नो टू हिम बिकॉज आई कुड सी दैट ही वाज सो कंपैशनेट विद इट, एंड आई थॉट इट वाज अ ब्यूटीफुल वे फॉर हिम टू लर्न कंपैशन. वेल एक्चुअली आई हैड वेरी फ्यू फ्रेंड्स हियर टुडे and they were somewhere very much a part of pushing me to do this, because when I was I've written it in my book also, the whole journey for me has been that you know, when I was pregnant and I was going to have a child, mujhe lagta tha ki yaar main, you know, it's very sad to say, lekin kahin pe ek thoda ego aa jata hai ki yaar maine itna to kar liya hai, ye bhi kar lungi, isme kaun si badi baat hai. But when I had the child, mujhe kaun si badi baat hai wo samajh mein aayi. And you know, parenting books don't tell you anything, and I couldn't kind of understand what was it that was going. Kai baar wo jo bata rahe the usme se mujhe mera answer nahi mil raha tha. My child was different. Tabhi maine realize kiya ki every child is different. I started listening to what my child, kya signals mera bachcha mujhe de raha hai. Aur wahan se phir maine observations ek you know, मेरी लिटरली ग्रोसरी लिस्ट की एक छोटी सी नोटबुक है, उसमें मेरे वो पॉइंट्स लिखे जाते थे हर महीने में. आज ये ख्याल आया, कुछ नोटिस किया, उससे मैंने क्या सीखा, जो मैं सीखती थी वो मैं नोट करती थी. कई बार मैं सीखती थी फ्रॉम वॉचिंग अ टेड टॉक और रीडिंग अबाउट समबडी, एंड समटाइम्स वो कोई पेरेंट भी नहीं होते थे, यू नो, दे वर नॉट नेसेसरली पेरेंट्स, दे वर, इट वॉज जस्ट लाइफ. एंड देन यू रियलाइज दैट इट्स नॉट अबाउट parenting, it's life's lessons, and that's what really kind of I would start noting down these lessons and start using them. And when you know, when I used to meet my girlfriends, aur hum log hamesha bolte the ki, you know, we are not going to be those girls who'll talk about children, but we all ended up talking about our kids, maids also, but yeah. So here we were, and then we said, yeah, we are doing the same thing, we are all discussing what we decided we would not do. And then it was more like, you know, ki what I did this is how it helped me, I did that, this is how it helped me. And you know, then my this little notebook would come out, and then they would tell me ke Sonali, you should compile it in a book. So it started that I will compile a few things into a book. Lekin jab main likhne lagi, this whole thing turned into I think this book became too personal. Itna personal ho gaya ye book eventually ki end mein jab likhne ke baad mein when I read it, I said, you know, I told Millie, my publisher, I said, you know, Millie, I'm really sorry to put you through this, but I can't publish it. It's too personal, I can't go through this. She said no. Or Millie was also going through, she had just delivered her baby, and she, while she was editing the book, and she's saying, you know, I'm attached to it, we have to publish it and all that. Then I gave it to Goldie to read the book, and I said, Goldie, I can't, this is our life, and if you're not comfortable, we will not publish it. So Goldie is not a reader, Goldie is dyslexic, you know, so for him reading is a thing. But he really read through it, he went through it really fast, he said, you know, it was catchy. And I had a chapter which I had spoken to him and had put those points about fathers. In fact, when he began the book, he said, you know what? I remember the same incident in a completely different way. This is not the way I was looking at it. He's saying, you know, we are friends. We are not the husband and wife who are not friends. We've been friends. We are best of friends. We talk to each other. And yet, he said, I didn't know you were going through this. And he said, you know, Sonali, that means there must be so many couples who don't even realize what they're going through, because with the hormones, I don't realize what I'm going through. So to understand that, this book needs to be out there. And he said, I'm so happy you've put a chapter on fathers. He said, because, you know, he knows a lot of his friends who are fathers, who are very hands-on fathers and who want to do a lot with their children. And he says, you know, I want it to be out there that it's cool to be a father. And even today in our country, a lot of times, ye to aurton ka kaam hai, ye tum kyun kar rahe ho? Which is not done. Don't you have a two-income household? Everybody is a working woman. No, you can't sustain a house unless there are two people working. So in the same way, parenting also requires two people. And it's cool when fathers help out, when fathers are hands-on, and I think a man looks more sexy when he's a great father.
Sonali, in your speech here, you said that when you watch TV,
so, you know, there are such horrifying things. Every day hear about some school, or some bomb going off in some school or on some road. And, you know, you constantly keep thinking that when will my, you know, you constantly hear about this bomb blast, the attacks. And you keep thinking that, yaar, ye mera bachcha ho sakta hai. What, when I go, what is this world going into? So you start getting, in fact, in the book I have said ki, I think मैं बिल्कुल middle class family से आती थी. मेरे घर में से कोई भी film industry में नहीं था. And I came out there. I have never had a mentor or a camp or anything. I've had good friends and I have done my bit. I was fearless, but I think I became fearful when I turned a parent, and that's what I mean by it. Because you start fearing for your child. You know, it changes you.
What are the challenges that you face while writing this book?
Listen, it's so, I don't know how you guys write, because it's a discipline and it's so difficult to be disciplined. So, you know, even to write that one paragraph, it's like you have to put your thought in and you have to, and I keep floating around and then I have to keep bringing it all back. But you know, the best thing about that was, now I know why they say you should write a diary, because you know, when I started writing things down, actually this book has been kind of introspection for me also. There have been so many things that I had forgotten. But you know, one thought led to another, then certain things led to certain understandings, which even at that point you don't realize, but as time passes, you realize. So for me, this book, I keep saying, is a journey, and it's been an introspection, and it's been kind of catharsis, you could say. Yeah, so maybe I need another catharsis in a little while now. I don't know. I'm very sure I'm not going to write fiction. But I don't know what it is that I will write. To be honest, there are a couple of ideas. But just the thought of putting that time and sitting in that disciplined way is putting me off it. You know, I've just finished my two shows. This book has been there. I feel like I just want to hibernate for some time and just kind of do nothing. Just be with Ranveer and home and do the, you know, just absolutely. Maybe something will fall into place with it, because even this book was just a compilation and it turned into something else. So I am going to let it grow into me and see where it goes.
Yeah, my first question is, when you wrote this experience of yours,
yeah.
You took your friends and also that your experience and their experience.
Yes, because whenever we spoke, we would get an idea, and there have been a lot of times when I have used the examples from my friends also, because I don't have like too many. I have very few friends, but they're really special and they are a great support system also. Like my family, they have been a great support system also. So yes, there is a lot of things that I learned from them also.
Sonali, does Ranveer also have aspirations to enter the film industry?
He's too young for that. Right now, he was very kicked about the fact, because you know, on the internet or on the Twitter, one of his school friends saw this and the girl said, Ranveer, your mama has written a book about you. That means you're the hero of that book. Mama, is that true? Is that what it means? He's quite innocent yet and he's a child. And I want him to remain a child for as long as I can pull it. They grow up really fast now. There's so much information out there, you cannot control the information. What would take us 5 years, they get it in one day, literally, you know, it's at their fingertips. So I think the challenge for a parent today is to preserve the innocence, and I really want to preserve his innocence.
How do you manage to keep the environment safe and not give him the impression that he's a star?
Because he's not. My Goldie makes sure that every time he's clicked, he says, "Ye aapki maa famous hai, isliye aapka photo nikala hai. Aapko karna hai kuch." This is reflected glory, as my husband tells, and I tell him that you're being so harsh. He's saying, "This is not harsh, this is correct." He has to understand this is reflected glory, as he calls it. I said, "Wow," but anyway, sometimes he's the bad cop, very rarely. Sorry. मैं अगर आप मेरा बुक पढ़ेंगे तो मेरा कहना ये है कि गुरुकुल में कुछ चीज़ें बताई जाती थी जो जब मैंने वो पढ़ा तो जहाँ पे आपको साइंस एस्ट्रोलॉजी म्यूज़िक लैंग्वेजेस ये सब सिखाया जाता था, उसके साथ में आपको स्पिरिचुअल ग्रोथ दी जाती थी जहाँ पे आप एज इवॉल्व होते थे एज अ पर्सन, ताकि जब आप गुरुकुल से निकले तो आप सोसाइटी में इंटीग्रेट ठीक से हो। तो मैं कह रही हूँ कि वो जो स्पिरिचुअल ग्रोथ जो है, वो जो टीचिंग्स जो हैं, वो गुरुकुल आपको अपने घर पर लाना है। सबके अपने तरीके हैं स्पिरिचुअलिटी के, एंड वो आई वुड से कि वो जो एक थोड़ा खालीपन मुझे लगता है हमारे स्कूल्स में, वो पार्ट थोड़ा खाली है, तो मुझे लगता है कि वो कमी एज पेरेंट्स वी हैव टू फिल इट। अभी न्यूक्लियर फैमिलीज होती जा रही हैं, अर्लियर कई बार दादा दादी नाना नानी वो वैक्यूम फिल करते थे, अभी भी वो कोशिश करते हैं, लेकिन भागदौड़ इतनी है ज़िंदगी में, बच्चे इतनी सारी चीज़ें करते हैं, दैट आई थिंक पेरेंट्स को ये रोल खुद पे लेना बहुत ज़रूरी है। नहीं हूँ, आई थिंक इट कैन बी बेटर। थैंक यू एवरीबॉडी, एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग, एंड आई एम श्योर प्लीज़ हैव योर टी एंड कॉफ़ी एंड आई विल जॉइन यू देयर।